Today, I'm going to go through a couple real-world tests with the MacBook Air M2 against the M1 Max Powerhouse MacBook Pro. Now, we should all pretty much know that the M1 Max is going to beat the M2 Air. But is that time savings worth the extra cost of the MacBook Pro? Let's find out. The first thing I did with these two machines was put them through a hard drive speed test just to see what the difference between the two were. Now, just so you know, the MacBook Air M2 has 512 gigs, while the M1 Max MacBook Pro has a full terabyte. The results still surprised me though, because the MacBook Pro was almost twice as fast in the read and write speeds. That's a massive difference between these two machines. If you don't know, usually the hard drive is kind of like one of those bottlenecks that you have when doing anything super taxing on the computer, because after the computer uses up all the RAM, then it has to rely on the hard drive speed to keep getting the task done. Now, the fact that the MacBook Pro does have twice the space as the MacBook Air could have an effect in that, but we have seen results saying that the M2 hard drives seem to be slower. Not sure if there's anything Apple can do with this. These hard drives just can't be internally upgraded. So something to look out for and something kind of concerning with just how much slower they are. But those tests don't really tell you everything. So I wanted to do a couple things that I did every day just to see how everything compared. So the first thing I did was just throw a simple iOS project at the device and just build and run and see how long it took for the simulator to go up. And honestly, this app was very simple. It's just a tvOS app. There's really not hardly anything in it. There's one Swift package that it has to manage. And I mean, it's the simplest of simplest. And in this case, it was only 3 seconds. There was a 3 second difference between the one launching and the other one launching. More complex apps are gonna take a little bit more. Most of the development stuff I do isn't super processing heavy. I don't do a bunch of animations in the app to where it's gonna require a lot more on the system. But what I do every day that does require a lot of processing and a lot of just need for speed is video editing. I do 4K video editing for this channel and my other channel, and that kind of stuff can require a lot of speed. So the first thing I did was I just kind of layered a few 4K videos, no real editing, just to see what kind of results I would get. And in this case, the M1 Pro Max came out ahead by about 37 seconds. Now these two computers, brand new, have nearly a $2,000 price difference. 37 seconds isn't really worth $2,000. So I figured, you know, this test wasn't really enough to compare the full speed. I needed to do something that was a little bit more. So I went ahead and threw a video at it that I'm gonna have coming out in the next week. This time I decided to compress the video a little bit more. So I went with the YouTube and Facebook option. I never actually use this option day to day just because it's not the one I would actually want. But I figured this was a good choice because it's gonna do more compression and it's gonna be more taxing on the computers themselves. This resulted with the M1 Max coming out ahead by 2.5 minutes. You might think, well, that's still not that much. But if you're doing this kind of stuff every day, multiple times a day, that adds up. And this project still wasn't that big of a project to where, you know, if you're doing 8K, you're doing 6K, you're doing like multiple layers, multiple levels. This was a fairly simple, but most of my projects are pretty simple. So for me, the MacBook Air is not that bad of a choice. The thing is you've got to decide what you need the computer to do. If you're just doing simple stuff, web browsing, you know, word processing, the M2 Air is going to be the perfect computer for you. It's lightweight, it can travel really easy, and it's just the great overall computer. But if you need a computer that has more power and can withstand longer processing because it has those fans it can turn on and it can continue to deliver that power, and you need that portability, there's nothing that's going to be the M1 Max right now. This thing is a powerhouse, and that's why I bought it. I bought this thing to just be able to really get work done, and I'm not going to need to replace it for multiple years to come. That being said, there's a $2,000 price difference between these two computers. I got my M1 Max for $800 off. If you want to see how I did that, you can click right here for this video. Hope you have a great one. God bless.